Chapter 6. Jane knew his father would be in Lacey's dinner eating his way, though he unusually lunch of beans, and father hates to be bothered at a meal. And unusually there would be no reason for it, at his dad's always said, "Northing never happened and explore, not even a traffic violence worth speaking of, something torturing fell into the lake, but so far nobody had drowned." But now his father was finally going to get something to sink his teeth into, just like he was always hoping for, burning into the dinner. Out of breath, he didn't even stop to shut the door behind him. "Dad," he yelled, skipping to a stop at the table. The sheriff was sitting in his favorite booth near the back, giving him a view of the main street and the rest of the dinner. He looked up from his place. "What in the hell is that?" he sounded merely annoyed. "Another dog got himself run over?" Ben Jane was a snucker for animals, and his dad knew it. Ben Jane was shaking. His face felt all tight. "You better come, then. They're a murderer." The sheriff shrilled, "Keep your voice down," he hissed. Too late. Everybody in the dinner turned to his. "Get a hold of yourself and tell me what's going on." He took a breath. "Need your phone? Me?" He was go out the old place in the woods. "Somebody been?" He fearful, lowering his voice to a whisper. "Chopping up in one of the old cabins." The sheriff looked suspicious. "Everybody we knew." People in the dinner laughing. "Come on, Dad. I'm serious. Luna was there. Blood all over the place and body parts." The sheriff gave him a long look. "You serious, boy? How do you know this isn't one of Laura's jokes?" "Dad, he wouldn't play a trick like this on me. He's said to be get you and come." "Why didn't you call me if it was such an emergency?" Jane was stuttered on that one. A flicker of donut past thought him was his friends pulling one of his dumb jokes. He quickly put it into suspicion. There was no Nina would be crazy enough to include Jane's father in a prank like this. He must called Ben Jane because he was so upset. An auto-tone punch ding the number on speed dial. That had to be it. The sheriff sighed and pushed his plate away. "Save my pudding," he called on Lisa as he hadn't pulled out of the booth. "One way or the other, I guess we better check it out." He stuck his hat on his head and went out the customer parking at the club. No need to put on the siren and light. Nobody on the streets will get out of the way. They went down Main Street and pulled into Lake Road. At the edge of the water, there was a bass and boat reeling shopped at Fish Co-Pilot and a catfish bar. The customer of the rattlesnake's building creates the kind of quatsnefsmear that brought people to this lake for fishing, but there was little else. Couple of shops in town, all junks, disgusting as canes. Down the highway was a motel and some fast food joints. The main thing about the lake was the rich people's summer cabins. They stucking around out into the cold water, their flat bottoms, packs, and ready. They had money, but didn't spend it on Dora. Went up to Africa instead. Around the far side of the lake, when there was the swamp, a ground speed towards the lake, and the compass trees stuck out their knees. There were depends, muds, logs, stucking just below the water, could slug to finish line, rip up a boat. Pacing of water, mountains, and here to the north, we resent chains, most of them in poor repairs now. At one time, the sheriff's father was alive. It was a popular place for people from Savannah to spend the summer. Back then, Dora had fancy ice cream parlors, restaurants, and there was talk of putting in a golf course that fell through. New people went to California for a Disney Explorer place that guardians. Big time fun. Dora didn't complain. The lake was long and wide and sports, and it took a while to get around to the site. If the illegal murderer, Benjamin, said excellently in his seat, standing against the seatbelt, they showed learning against the funnel of these shiny purple trucks smoking. He didn't look too upset, the sheriff observed up loudly. But then he saw the boy's hands was shaking, was bought the cigarette to his lips. Benjamin leaned out of the car to join his friends, learn against the cabin, and started talking to the sheriff. Got out more slowly, appearing the scene. As he approached the boys, he noticed his son was turning green around the grill. As he listened to what Laura said to... Hold on there, the sheriff said, starting from the belting, and tell it to me. It isn't Ben. Jane was to fill out the request. Lauren stopped to attend to curse himself in their blood and guts all over. Make me punk. He points to the long glass. The sheriff passed intense. Take your words for your son. So you're thinking this is a murder scene. Kid watch too much TV. The sheriff couldn't help thinking. Must be, Lauren said. And what's making you so sure? Lots of blood, plethora of bodies. Look like one went crazy here.
And you, how do you happen to be here, hanging around a murder scene? Lois looked scared. What do you mean?
I was out here. I was looking for... I weren't doing nothing. Okay,
hold on. Let me take a look. The sheriff walked up to the cabin door, which was hanging off its hangers. It seemed dead bodies, and this time Lori and Hingo. He seemed dead bodies, and this time Lori and Ben Jane could take all the blood and guts. They saw it in movies and video games, but a little of the real stuff shook them up pretty badly. Ben Jane watched his father disappear through the doorway. The woods seemed so quiet, and a few whispers rusting. A far-off bird call. What if the murderer was still around? He looked nervous all over his shoulders. Then he heard his father's voice. What the hell is this? He and Lori grasped at each other, stealing them sleeves. A bad news. Maybe it was somebody they knew. The sheriff came out of the porch. He stood there a moment looking at them, and then he started laughing. Ben Jen thought his father had a bad reaction, a kind to fit the nervous absence. But after a few minutes, he realized his father really was just laughing it like it was funny. He was laughing so hard he knew had to bend over and hold his knees. You too, he said. When he got control, a murderer, he waded into Lori and noticed it's a bunch of damp possums and raccoons, maybe a wild bear, maybe it's a nail. But I didn't see no fur, Lori said.
Call Dr. Vineland. The sheriff pulled his phone out of his pocket. But the vet, Dad, Ben Jane said, right, you got dead animals. You call the vet. But if it's a murder, the sheriff looked at Benjamin precisely. It's not a murderer. Human. So it's not exactly murder. Benjamin thought of the people who had been to jail for hurting animals, beating dogs, and letting cats starve to death. Maybe some sicko bought animals here just to torture them. He didn't like the idea. He moved to go up the cabin to look inside, but his dad called him back. He wouldn't let them go near the cabin again until the vet arrived. As they stood around, they gradually been too small. Lori punked. Lori lifted one cigarette after another. Then sheriff glared at the butts on the ground. You got give that habit up, boy. You never heard of cancer? Yeah, I know. I'm trying to get it. You mean Ben slang? Ben Jane, second, but Lori still just looked stunning when Dr. Vernon finally got there. He and the sheriff spent a while inside the cabin, mumbling and coughing and
cursing the mess that had started to smell a lot worse than Lauren vocal. Then the vet came out. He said he agreed with the sheriff, but it made it sound more serious. A large predator had attacked some small animals, probably a bear, the doc said, which Ben Jane thought was shame more reality than an eel. Then isn't any eels wandering around their grassland woods, but bears were a possibility. Through Ben Jane thought had never seen one. Anyways, he wasn't convinced a bear would have needed a large opponent to eat raccoons, rabbits, squirrels like they were stews or something. How could a bear even get so many animals together at once? It was almost like it's ordered to take out meal. But when the possums, the question to Doc Fania, the man said he would have caught them one by one. Maybe they had made the chain linger. He just brought his food back to enjoy his luxury meal. Nothing strange about it. So much blood, Benjen thought, after he sneaked a look inside black of plaster where it had died. Other had a smell of its own, like their iron pots. Then there were mixtures of smells starting to make him sick. Okay, if we're going back, he said his dad. The sheriff looked at the vet. Think we can let this to very measuring go? The man laughed. Lori looked a little pissed. Ben Jane didn't say goodbye, just got in Lori's truck. Ben Jane couldn't shake what was in his gut. Was they drove away. He tormented his eyes from his dad's and the vet and looked at his friend. So, what do you think? He asked. Lori stared straight ahead as the dove. Like your dad said, it's just animals. I guess it was dumb to get worked up. Ben Jane was still doubtful. I just don't know. You don't think it was? I definitely a weird feeling. Why would a bear toss the juggage like that? It looked like kind of thing someone does to in a range when he really angry and out of control. Maybe that's the way bears feel. Lona gave a weak grin as a joke. I'm sure not, don't know. I just feel stupid. Jen Bam shook his head. You don't the right thing. What if it had been a murderer? He could shake the feeling that there was a wrong thing in it, something in the crib that's still hanging in the air. His father didn't seem it at all. Just thought it was funny cigarettes matched up Like a huge animal prize, Benjen felt sorry for them. He felt sorry for anything.
That ends up dying that anyway. You know, he said, thinking out loud. After they finished, why don't we go back up and take another look around? Geez, I don't know, Benjen. You're not scared, are you, Benjen? Himself was a little scared, but he wasn't going to say so. I just to admit it was spooky, but I agree with you. It felt weird. I seen dead rats and rabbits that some cats caught. My dad ate a whole swallowed mold once. You should have been it. He was coughing, and it opened his jaws, and there was the mold looking out of his throat. But I never saw anything like that messed up in that crib.
So, we agree. Let's go back. Maybe we'll find something. They're missing. Yeah, like we CSI guys, right? You heard what your father called us. Benjen didn't think his father would give up it already. Thought made a swamp judgment. There he was corning plans that nothing expect happened to Danny, looking at blaming that mess on a hungry bear was lame. Benjen was just didn't believe a bear would stuck up that way, almost like taking a trip to a supermarket. He was sure they were missing something important. Loring expect his thoughts. But if it's not a bear, who or what would do something like that? Benjen shook his head. Thoughts. My father think it's nothing. Seriously, but because it's just a bunch of dead animals, always dead animals first. You knew torture cats and dogs before they moved on to human victims. You're out there, man, Lauren said. You know some strange stuff. But Benjen knew that in the world outside of Doran, some of the strange stuff was actual facts. He done a lot of reading on the subject. He couldn't help wondering what if there was some sort of serial killer on the loose. Now that was something his father would have to take notice of.